Bitch needs to fix her fucking wig. Oh my god. Whew. What's up? This your boy Zanny111, and y'all tuning into the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. Walk a walk a hell, bitch.
Taste it, girl. Taste it. Taste it. Wow.
You like my fire, you like my fire.
Woo! Hey, you all, it's Bimbo Winehouse. Checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. Let me just get my get right, alright? Let me get my get right before I can get you right, baby. Woo!
I'll stand
there. Yeah, baby. Oh. You knocked me out, girl.
Hey,
hell, baby. Shout out to all my party people out there. Woo! Woo, shit. Oh, shit. Hola, hola, hola. Pour them drinks, baby. Pour them drinks, baby. You checking out the messiest show on YouTube.
And drop it like it's hard.
Come on, come on, Mr. Madison. Make it do what it do, baby.
Girl, need people like me. Need people like you to come together.
You know about this, baby. Do the robot. Oh, shit. Taking it back, baby. Yeah! Drop it like it's hard. Woo! Shout out to D, the Diva, baby. Shout out to all my old school, baby. You know, these youngers don't know about this, baby. Oh, baby. Oh. The youngers don't know about my girl. Oh. Yes, D. Make it do what it do, baby. Dip it low, dip it low, dip it low, ew. What? Dip it low, dip it low, dip it low, ew. Oh, this is the part. We about to get into the show. Relax, relax, alright? Having a little Bimbo party right now, baby.
Do you ever felt before?
Just about to relax, girl. Fix your wig, girl.
Don't break it.
Woo! All right. I know we all stressed out. We all going through shit in life right now. Believe me, we are all going through something. If it ain't one thing, it's another. We all got problems, but for the next hour, I want you to just forget about your problems, girl. I want you to forget everything that you're going through right now. That job stressing you out. Your man stressing you out. You ain't got no money, honey. You broke. You hungry. You ain't got shit going on in your life. Are you just stressed out? Just relax for a minute. And just, ooh, baby. You fucking somebody else's guy, honey. Alright, we gotta, they just don't make music like this no more. Alright. There's somebody else's guy. Sister Madison. Alright, hold on, let me pause the music. Wait, let me just hear the first verse real quick. Wait, listen. Times we spent together, baby. Boom, 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 boom. You was somebody else's god. Woo! I can't let go. All right. I'll get back to my music once the show is over, okay? Okay, Sister Madison, relax. Okay, all you youngins, I'm sorry I'm not playing Nicki Minaj or Lil Wayne or Beyonce, whatever these little young kids are listening to, okay? I'm old school, baby. This is old school, honey. Yes, I'm 28 years old. I'll be 28 in what, 2 months? But baby, this is old school, honey, okay? I'm 28 in gay life. I'm really 68, because you know we gay, man, we die. So I'm really 68, honey. You know, we, like I said, we gay, man, we die so soon. You know, because of AIDS and cancer and all that shit. So I'm 68, honey. I'm about to die, honey. I'm trying to live, baby. So just relax, okay? Relax. Okay, I'm old school. You looking at old school. You come in my computer and you look at the music I have. Teddy, Diana Ross, and the Supremes, honey. Gladys Knight and the Pimps, Aretha Franklin. You might see 2-3 little Nicki Minaj songs in there, okay? But I'm old school, baby, okay? I'm old school. Shout out to all my old school 80s, 70s, 60s, okay? I'm old school. Alright, let me get to the show. Whew, that takes so much energy out of me. Listen here, you nappy-headed hoe. Relax, okay, bitch? Relax. We're gonna get to the show, okay? You need to go find your wig, bitch, okay? Listen. So, me and Sister Patterson, well, yesterday we was arguing. We had a big argument down here. Like, we was going at it. Sister Patterson don't understand. Why is it I do not like men? I don't like men. I don't like straight men. I don't like gay men. I don't like men. I don't like short men, tall men, Jamaican men, black men, Asian men, Dominican men. I don't like men. I don't like men. I don't like men. She don't understand why is it I don't like men and I'm gay. Well, it's not nothing for you to understand, bitch. And it's not nothing for you all not to understand. Like, I don't like men. And yes, I grew up without a father. But believe me, that's not the reason why I don't like men. Men are just stupid. Men are really stupid. And I just use men for their dick. That's it. I don't want a relationship with you. There's only two words that men need to tell me, and that's I'm coming, okay? Okay, when you on your way over here, you text me and let me know that you are coming, I'm coming. Or when that big black dick is in my mouth, baby, okay? And you's about to bust that nut, okay? I need to hear you say, I'm coming. And after you come, and I come, get out, okay? Go back to your baby moms, your baby falls, whoever you with. I don't give a fuck, okay? I don't like men. And it's, I just can't explain it. Like, I hate men. Men, to me, are just like stupid creatures. They are stupid. I love females, and I really, really wish I was straight. Like, if I was straight, I think I would have the perfect life. But then again, no, because I would have to deal with stupid straight men. I can't fucking stand men. I understand you lesbians who hate men. I get it. I cannot stand dykes who try to act like men. Like, I don't understand females who want to be men. Like who want to dress like men. Like, you are a female, honey. You can change your looks a million times. Dudes, we have one look, okay? A fitted hat and, you know, short haircut. Like, females, you can wear short hair, long hair, dresses. You can even dress like a dude and not get criticized for it. Furthermore, I'm losing my train of thought about men. Oh, someone was telling me, like, the way through men is through sports, because you know men love sports. And you know, for a day, Sister Patterson, like, and you were always really sitting here trying to figure out sport teams and if the Jets play the Knicks. I don't know. I don't watch sports. It's boring to me. A bunch of men just boring. So I was like, no, I'm not doing all that. Okay, a man's gonna like me for me. If you don't, oh well, move on. But, oh, excuse me. I don't like men. That's it. In the discussion. If you don't get it, oh well, okay. If you do get it. I don't like men. Men are stupid. They just stupid. I just don't like men. Fuck you if you don't get. Fuck you, bitch, okay? I haven't. When was the last time you got your pussy in, bitch? Okay, I haven't seen no man down in this dungeon with you. Yeah, you been playing with that pussy, bitch. Are you nigga? Bitch, I've been listening, bitch. Yeah, I had one man, bitch. You can't. I have more men than you now. You not have one man down here, man. Have one man. I'll suck them good right there, bitch. Okay? You not have no man down here. You play with your pussy, bitch. You play, bitch. This is what you play with, bitch. Okay? Minol, Sister Patterson. Minol, don't try me, bitch. Anyway, you all. Welcome to the Bimbo Wine House Addiction Show. Thank you to whoever did that intro. Remember, if you want to send an intro, you can send me an intro at bimbowinehouse@gmail.com. Furthermore, I have an address where you can send me some donations for this show. And some gifts. I'll get that at the end of this show. Cause you ain't gonna know. Patterson. You know, we ain't gonna have no crazies trying to know our address. So I had to go to the post office and give me a P.O. box or a post box. So if you want to send some stuff, you can send it over there to City Hall. You could blow them up, but you ain't gonna know where I live at. You know, this is a little dungeon. I ain't got much going on, but I don't need none of you crazies who's obsessed with me knowing where I live at. Oh, no, honey. Okay, you ain't gonna come up in here, honey, unless you bring some big fat dick and a bottle of Bacardi or Mano. Oh, by the way, somebody had asked, what is it that I drink? The Long Island. This is it right here. Go to the liquor store and look for this. This bottle here was what, $10? This shit will get you fucked up, honey. You ain't gotta mix it with nothing. Just put a little lemon in it. It'll be alright. Alright, you all. I have a good show planned for you all. I have the Loving It or Come Again. And today's song features Jaheim. Do you remember Jaheim? Sister Madison, the last time, you know, we heard from Jaheim was when he showed up at Whitney Houston funeral in Newark, New Jersey, looking like a Barney, okay? I don't know where he was going in his outfit, okay? But apparently he took 3 years off and he said, you know what, they want to call me Barney, I'm going to go in there and show them. And you showed us, baby, because I'm loving this new track. The track is called Age Ain't a Factor. So we're going to get to that towards the end of the show. Plus, excuse me, I have an email from a young bisexual female, and she has a friend who claims, a straight friend who claims that she's 100% straight. But honey, this 100% straight female cannot keep her hands off the bisexual chick, and she don't know how she can get her, because when she asked her if she was gay, the straight girl denied it, but she always got her hands on her femur, on her breast. So we're gonna get to that email later in the show. Plus, I have some sexiness. I know you all are sick of looking at my fat ugly ass and Sister Patterson Lauryn Hill looking ass. So I have some sexiness. I have three dudes, and I'm going to show you some eye candy, baby. They sexy. So stay tuned for that. Plus some karaoke. I want to do a dedication to Mac Daddy. That was one half of Chris Cross. You know, he died last week due to a drug overdose, to my understanding. So I'm going to karaoke Chris Cross, their number one hit, Jump. So stay tuned for that. And plus, we have your celebrity tea. Okay, we will address one of my favorite porn stars of all time, Mr. Marcus, Trey Songz. And yes, we will talk about the Queens, Anton Donson, what's the other one named, Mr. C, and all other Queens. So just stay tuned for that, honey. Okay, and much more. You're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. We're about to pause for the intro, and I'm going to put my steak on, honey, okay? I'm going to put salt on it, some black pepper, some onions, okay? Some garlic. What else we going to put on that steak, honey? Whatever else we going to put on it, honey. Then I'm going to make some mashed potatoes with some string beans, honey. Oh, it's about to be on in Bimbo's Dungeon, honey. I'm about to cook down, honey. About to cook down to the ground. All right, you all. Stay tuned. You're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. I'll be right back with you. And, we got to talk about your girl, too, Lauryn Hill. Since you trying to be like her with this old natural shit. Okay? Stay tuned, you all. We'll be right back. You're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse. Oh. Hey, bye, bitch. Use that. We'll be right back. Wonka wonka. Yeah. Oh shit.
here we go. Oh shit. Yes, you better dip it low. Oh shit. I'm on the dance floor. I don't give a fuck. I'ma take that dick and take it out my butt. I got a juicy ass and a big ass cock. Y'all know this weight, I just won't stop. I'm not Korean, but I get super head. I'ma choke on that dick until I'm dead. I'm a nasty hoe, I'm a freak bitch. Come on, me boys, y'all watching that addiction shit. Ow! Yes! Dip it low. Ew. And break it up slow. Ow, yes, zip it low. And here we go.
Alright, bitch, can we stop the motherfucking show?
Ow,
yes, baby. Alright, it's the addiction show, let's go.
Whatever. Hey, you all. No, just mad open just now. I was just real happy. Shout out to you all out there with a Black Gay Chat account. Do you have a BGC account? That's Black Gay Chat. You know, it's a Black Gay Chat line. Black Gay BGC. Black Gay Chat. That's where like these DO men go find over DO men. Whatever. Anyway, I have an account on there. My name is Winehouse without the E. So search me, send me a message, okay? But anyway, do you ever get gas, like you have no messages, and then finally you know you log into your account and it said one new message? I was like, yes, baby, somebody sent me a message, baby, girl. And then I check the freaking message and it's a fucking advertisement. Like, I don't give a fuck about no fucking advertisement. Oh. I don't get no messages on there. Like, what I do? Like, I show my ass and my dick. I don't get nothing. Nobody want my fat, ugly ass. But my drag queen pictures, I have two accounts. I have one for Bimbo, and then I have one for D. That's the drag queen when I got the wig on. Baby, I can check that D's account every day. Mama will have over 10 messages a day. But Bimbo ass don't get shit. I haven't got a message from BGC in almost a year. Like, and then sometimes I put, like, you know, a fake picture of somebody else to draw people attention. And then, like, I show them my, like, I just don't get no message. Anyway, the paid advertisement is about a sex party, honey. Yes, it's about a sex party from Zone Amsterdam. Private freak sessions. Spring has arrived, so bring the action. They got sex parties in Atlanta, Houston, and Chicago. What are they saying about Atlanta? All real freaks nationwide, stay in the know. All men and boys will be in the zone nationwide. New Atlanta, West Midtown location, as always, open 6 nights and days weekly. What's the address? 925 Bowen Street, NW, Unit 8, Atlanta, Georgia, 30318, inside Go Hard Fitness. What is this about? I wanna go, baby. Open 10 p.m. through 5 a.m. Sunday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. $10 entry. Atlanta Midday Express hours of operation. Okay? What are they saying? So, we sell poppers. $7 for small bottle. What are poppers? That's some liquor? Hey, $7 for small bottle or 2 for $12. Jingle Juice Platinum, Jungle Juice Black, Amsterdam. Hold on. Oh, I've been waiting for that one to come out. I'm sorry. Oh. Yes, baby. Damn. God damn. It's a spider to cover your nose, bitch. Damn, this my shit, fuck you, okay, don't act like you out there, you don't fart, you know you fart, honey, alright, you don't fart, damn, that shit stink. Alright, back to this, they also have lube on sale, Wow, I need to go to this. Shout out to you all who's gonna go to these Amsterdam's download sex parties. I haven't been to a sex party in years. They boring to me now. They mad boring. Like, I remember the first sex party I went to, I was 15. Yes, I started young, baby. I was 15 years old, and I walked in. It was me, my friend Tony, Brandon, and it was this other dude. I forget his name, but anyway, it was on 135th Street in Harlem on Martin Luther King Boulevard. And we would walk in, and then we would have to take the elevator to the 16th floor. And then once you got the elevator, the apartment was on your right. And I remember the first time we walked in, it was a shower curtain. We was like, what the fuck is this? And the guy was like, you never been here? We was like, no. He was like, well, just know when I pull the shower curtain across, you're going to see a whole bunch of naked men. And you know my little horny gay ass. I was like, all right, baby. Baby, he pulled that shower curtain across. I was like, wow. But everybody was naked. So he was like, y'all got to take your clothes off. And you know me, 14, 15, I'm like, I'm taking my clothes off. So Tony was like, yeah, take these fucking clothes off. So anyway, make a long story short, we took our clothes off. I mean, we kept on our boxes and all that, but we took our clothes off, whatever. And they had like juices. You remember them 25 juices, the crackhead juices they used to sell? He had those, the tato chips. And then they had a room. It's like three different rooms. It was a dark room. Baby, I'm talking out of school. I've been through many a sex parties, but I'm just trying to talk like this was my first one, which was my first one. They had a dark room. They had the living room, which had the TV. Porn was on. And, you know, the bathroom, whatever. So, for like 2 to 3 hours, me and Tony, all of us, we were like in the living room, scared, nervous, like, Bimbo, what did you... Because I brought them too, okay? I brought them there. I didn't know what type of party it was, but I brought them there because I got the flyer. So he's like, Bimbo, what did you bring us to? I'm like, I don't know, baby, but just relax. Mind you, they was all older than me. Like, I've always been mature for my age. These was like 20, 21, 22. I'm like 14 years old, 15, but you thought I was like 21. Anyway, look, I remember we went into the dark room. It was complete darkness, just dark. You couldn't see nothing. All you could walk in there and just feel bodies. And that's why you had to have a sexy body, because that's how people determined if they wanted you was by the body. Because if you saw fat, biggie, smalls, they might want you. Oh, hell no. Back up, okay? Back up, bitch, okay? Anyway, I remember the door opened. And when the door opened, the dark room, a little bit of light came. And I seen this one dude. He had his thong on. I was like, damn, Tony, go get him. He's like, Bimbo, stop beating, because I'm a shy, I'm very shy. I was like, Tony, go get him. Anyway, Tony went to go get dude. Dude came back in the dark room. He came out to me. He was like, oh, your friend told me you like me. I was like, yeah. I just wanted to feel your butt. So, like, I was just, his butt was so nice. I remember just playing with his butt cheeks, and I just jerked off. I was jerking off. And, like, me being young, I guess he wanted to get fucked, because I didn't know. I just liked his butt, and I nutted to that. But, baby, I've been to many a sex parties. I can tell you about the one in Mashulo Parkway in the Bronx, the one in Brooklyn, Jefferson. You take the A train to Kingston Troop, and you get off and walk down to Jefferson, where it's the couple. Baby, I've been through a lot of stuff. I've been to the best sex party I think I don't know, but the best night I had a sex party. Yes, I'm a slut. Okay, I woke in my truth. Okay, I'm a slut. I don't give a fuck what you say. I'm a slut. Fuck you. The best sex party, Sister Patterson, you all remember I went to, was in the Bronx. No, in Brooklyn. This was the one in Brooklyn on Kicks and Troop. And I was sexy and slim. It was all these thugs in there, and I was young and sexy. I walked in there, had my little boxes on. One dude just grabbed me, and like, he was just sucking on my ear. And then another dude came and started sucking on my nipples. And then another dude came, he started sucking my dick. And then there was another dude that came and started eating my ass. I had like 5 dudes just all over me. Like 5 different dudes just licking all over me, sucking me off, eating my ass. I was waiting for one to come suck my toes, honey, but anybody suck the toes. Anyway, I bust the best nuts, yo. And when I nutted, they all nutted. Like, they was all, I don't know, I guess I was young and sexy and slim. Not this old fat, ugly queen now. But, that was the best night ever I could remember. Don't get me wrong, I had some good times at the sex parties. But that night, baby, that took the cake. Baby, oh, that was a good night. He was on my, he was like, you like that shorty? I was like, yes, daddy. Oh, this is what makes me want to lose weight and get back to them. Oh, I'm so sexy and skinny. Now I'm this fat, ugly mess. Whatever. I don't care. If I don't ever get dick again or nothing, nobody want my fat, ugly ass ever again. I had my shit, baby. I lived, honey. Okay, I lived. I done had enough dick and ass. I'm happy. I'm satisfied. So, if nobody ever in this world want me again, whatever, baby, I lived. I got my hands, and I got my lube, and I'm good, okay? I don't care if nobody ever else want me in this motherfucking world, since the baddest, I done had my shit, baby. I am fine with that, baby, okay? Moving on. What are we talking about? Oh, I want to shout out to, what's this bitch name? Sheryl Underwood. I don't know if you guys watch her. She comes on CBS Channel 2. This is some show. She's on some talk show with a whole bunch of other four other hoes. Three white hoes. I don't know. Anyway, she's following me on Twitter. Thank you, Sherry. I love Miss Sheryl. And what I love about Sheryl Underwood is that this woman walks in her truth. Mama knows she look like Wesley Snipes. Look at her. Don't she look like just ugly? You ain't got no alibi, Sherry, because you's ugly. But Mama, what I love about her, she's 49, and you can't tell her she's not ugly. She will let you know to your face, I'm ugly. I know I look like a man. I know I'm black. I look like Biggie Smalls' mama. I know this is what I love, and I love her. She walk in her truth, just like me. Like, no one can tell me I'm gay, I'm too gay, baby. I know this, baby, okay? Can't no one tell me I'm fat, black, and ugly. Baby, this is stuff I will tell you. No one can ever put you down if you walk in your truth. Things that you say about yourself, other folks can't ever say about you. You get what I'm saying, Sister Patterson? So if you want to be a nappy-headed hoe, bitch, you let the world know I am a nappy-headed hoe, and I need a wig, honey, okay? People can't come up to you and diss you. So I say all that to say, shout out to Sheryl Underwood and walk in your truth, baby. You are ugly, bitch, but you know this. This is why you are where you at now. You on TV, you doing your thing, because you ain't fronting. You ain't trying to be some sex symbol, bitch. You know you ugly, bitch, okay? You know you's an ugly bitch. I know I'm fat, black, and gay, bitch. I know this. Moving on to your celebrity tea. I'm twisted, y'all. Yo, I'm fucking twisted. Alright, baby, it's time for your celebrity tea. Let's kill these two birds with this one stone. No, wait, better yet, Sister Patterson. In their case, let's kill these two queens, baby, okay? With one big dick, okay? We're gonna kill you two queens with this one dick. And these two queens, baby, is Mr. C, the Hot 97 DJ, and that other queen, Anton Donson. Baby, I had to write my notes down because I didn't want to forget nothing. This is your celebrity tea. You guys know this world, Sister Patterson, this whole world is obsessed with gay people. I really didn't want to spend too much time on this because you are so obsessed with the gays in this world. But I just want to just talk about it real quick. So, Mr. C, you all saw my last previous video, you know, I spoke on him, but I just want to speak a little more on him. Mr. C, I just have to say that you are in denial. You are in true denial of who you are. Sidebar, Sister Patterson, you guys, I didn't know he was of African descent. Yes, Mr. C is some type of African descent. Baby, them African men, okay, them Jamaican men, only if you knew, okay, but those be the biggest homophobes, but honey, believe me, those be the biggest homos. But anyway, back to you, Mr. C. A lot of folks are saying that, like I said, I heard your interview this past Monday with the Rosenberg Morning Show, and a lot of people are saying you have a problem. I don't think Mr. C have a problem, you all. He's just like most of you fucking download men out there, okay? You men think just because you get your dick sucked by a fucking fucking transsexual or by another gay motherfucker, you are not gay because you didn't touch no dick, eat no ass, fuck no ass. Understand something. If a man sexually does anything to you, I don't care if it's suck your dick, lick your toes, baby, eat your ass. I don't give a fuck if you not in his mouth. You've been fucking a pussy and then you pull that dick out and you not that dick in the man's mouth. You are fucking gay or bisexual. These men cannot understand this. Mr. C is 46. So, at this age, if he ain't been real with us, I don't think he's ever going to be real, okay? Furthermore, the interview that you had at Hot 97, I was listening, but I stopped listening after the fact. He said, if I'm hiding that I'm in the closet, well, that's my business. Sister Patterson, did you hear it? At one point in the interview, he told them, if I'm hiding the fact that I'm in the closet, that is my business. If I'm hiding the fact that I'm gay, that's my business. At that point in the interview, he was letting you all know I'm gay, and I'm hiding it, and I'm not going to come out the closet. So you can sit me here all my fucking day in this interview, ask me if I'm gay. I'm going to deny, because I'm going to hide it, okay? And that's my motherfucking business. I just think it's a crazy situation that these men truly believe that they're 100% straight. I don't think he's fully gay, like that next swing I'm about to get into, Anton Dawson, but I think Mr. C is bisexual. I just wish they would have asked, are you bi? You know what I'm saying? Like, I wish they would have just said, are you gay? No, these men are not 100% gay. Like, I'm gay, okay? I will never be in no pussy. I don't like pussy. Pussy is just nasty. My dick will never get hard off no pussy. But Mr. C, yes, his dick might get hard off some pussy. But me, I'm gay, honey. Mr. C is bisexual. And then, speaking on what actually happened, he said in an interview that he was leaving some club, and then he needed to stop to call someone to tell him about Summer Jam. So you stopped on the corner what's known for, it's not even transsexual. That's another thing. Everyone is confusing this story about Mr. C was trying to pick up a transsexual. No, baby. Where Mr. C stopped, the corner that he stopped, to my understanding, these are men. These are thugs who are just looking to make a little change. So they exchange it for some sex. So to my understanding, he was trying to pick up a little regular gay dude. This wasn't no, you know, drag queen or no tranny. This was just, so I'm thinking he likes it all. Trannies, regular gay, as long as he's gonna suck that dick, he's happy with it. So he said he stopped to call someone, and then somebody came up to some female Latino came up to the car to ask him a question or for some directions or something, and come to find out it was a prostitute, but it was an undercover cop. And then he said, no, I have to go. And then when he went away, all these cops and hell, Mr. C, yo, use a fucking meatball. First of all, as a former escort prostitute, I'm a proud prostitute, honey, okay? Bitch, you's a prostitute, bitch. Okay, don't sit up here and lie, bitch, okay? One thing about me, I keep it real with you motherfuckers. Yes, I used to sell his dick and ass, and I made some coins, but I stopped doing it because I cannot deal with the men, okay? I hate men, so no, okay? But I'll say this. We are never supposed to talk price, okay? I've learned that. Prostitute 101. You never talk price to the customer. You let them say a price. Furthermore, you get in the car and you touch on their dick, because a cop is not going to let you go butt for so far. So when I used to escort down there, or we hawking in the village area and around the village area, when I used to meet these dudes, I never talked price. The conversation was started around, like, you know, the dude would drive by, whatever. I'll be at the bus stop, like, I'm looking, and he'll stop his car, and then I'll be like, hey, what's up? I mean, he'll be like, hey, what's up? I'll be like, hey, what's up? Whatever, the conversation goes on to whatever. And then somehow I'll get into the car. I don't remember, because I remember one dude, he told me to meet him around the corner. All I know is I never talk price until I knew this customer was legit. This was not a cop, okay? So your story just didn't make sense at all. I think the whole, and I have to salute Hot 97 off the simple fact, Sister Patterson. Ebro, that's the program director of Hot 97. He just kept saying, we support you, we support you. They was giving you a fucking chance to come out the closet. They was, we don't care if you're gay. We just want you to be honest. And I think you took the low road, you meatball. Understand, Mr. C, had you would have came out the closet, the first major hip-hop DJ to come out the closet, baby, you would have been bigger than Funkmaster Flex, honey, okay? You would have been huge. You would have been DJing at all the gay NYC prides. You would have been making them coins. Stop giving a fuck what people think about you. This is what I think happened here. He cares too much of what you all think. Please, I will never give a fuck. Furthermore, like I said, he's of African descent, and also the whole Jamaican thing, and I don't know, I just think, Mr. C, I don't think he needs help. I just think he's like most down low men. You all truly believe you are straight. Just because you haven't put the dick in your mouth, or you haven't got fucked in your ass, you're still straight, because you're the one, you're the dominant one. You're still a man, but I will say this to you, Mr. C. You're gonna do it again, okay? Like, you are a freaking meatball. After listening to that interview, you have a problem, but not like that, like a mental problem. You're gonna do it again, and this time I hope it's with me, baby. Baby, I hope it's with me, baby. I'm gonna be recording. What? But anyway, shout out to Mr. C. What do you all think? I know it's going to happen again. I know he's a meatball. Men like this, you are addicted, honey. When you are addicted, I got to salute him, because he did say he's what's the word I'm looking for? He has noticed his problem. Like, he knows he has a problem with the prostitute. That's another thing. Why can't prostitution be illegal in the world? Like, if someone want to sell yourself, why is the cops hating? Go out there and find these people that's killing people and robbing. If I want to sell myself, make a little coins, okay, because I can't find a job, why must you deal, like, mind your business, okay? We are both satisfying each other. He's going to pay me to suck my dick. I'm going to suck his dick and leave me the fuck alone. It's better than me going out here robbing somebody. I cannot fucking stand cops, you fucking pigs. Let prostitution be legal. Anyway, moving on to the next queen, Anton Dodson. Ugh, I didn't want to talk about him. I really didn't want to talk about this fucking queen kid. Anyway, I just I never liked him, even from that video. We have a problem, okay? Hide your kids. I never liked him. I'm the type of gays I can't fucking deal with. I cannot stand them type of gays. Anyway, all weekend long, he has been trying to convince us that he's now straight. He's no longer gay. And he wants a wife and some kids. Well, before I give my opinion, these two ladies have something to say, okay? Hit it.
Got time for that?
Exactly. Ain't nobody got time for that shit. First of all, I have to say, I want to ask my females out there, who is going to sleep with that? Who is going to let this mesh right here fuck you and then come up in you and you's gonna spit out a baby? But then again, there's some desperate females out there. Like, there's females out there who want to fuck my fat, ugly ass, gay ass. And I'm like, are you serious? You want to fuck me? Like, are you that fucking desperate? So I'm convinced there's some females out there, off the strength of him being famous, that will let him come up in them and get that baby out. But Anton, you are just like a lot of these other men who try to fight off that feeling of being gay. You can't. It's never going to go away. I saw a video of him. He was saying that, you know, sometimes he still look at a dude and go, ooh, I gotta control myself. You can't fucking control yourself. Let that dude come over and say it was good, baby. You gonna be on your knees sucking that dick. You fucking men make me sick. I'm glad I walk in my truth and I don't try to front and be something else that I'm not. I just think, at first I thought this queen was like looking for like 15 minutes, another 15 minutes, because you know his 15 minutes has been over, but he's been looking for another 15, but I truly believe at this point he's trying to become a straight man and just live righteous according to the Bible and all that. Let me tell you something, I don't read the Bible, I have not read the Bible, I read one chapter, Genesis, in the beginning, God said, let there be light. That was it. I don't pay attention to the Bible. I don't read that Bible. My thing is, my motto is, live your life accordingly how you want to live it, as long as you are not harming the next person. If you're not physically harming another person, live your life. That means if you want to drink every motherfucking day, honey, drink. If you want to smoke weed every day, live your life. If you want to fuck every day, I don't read the Bible. Shout out to all you Christians out there who's, I'm saved, I live for the Lord, and shut up, okay? I'm not saved, I ain't none of that bullshit. Me and God have our own relationship, that's enough for me. But however you want to live your life, Anton, but baby, 10 years down the line, I may not see you trying to, or some porn sucking the dick, honey. Talk about you missed it, honey, okay? You men kill me trying to fight off this hoe. I'm not gay. And then you get into these marriages and relationships with females just to try to front and prove and try to cover up who you you know, Antoine, you are a lady, honey. You is a queen, honey, okay? Get back to reality, honey. This is what you like, baby. This is what you like, honey. You don't like this nasty shit, bitch, okay? This is what you like, baby. You like I'm gonna suck it. Anyway, moving on. I'm just glad I woke in my truth, okay? Because these men truly kill me, trying to be something that they're not, okay? Moving on. What do you, like, let me know y'all comments. Am I wrong here? But you were like, Mr. C's gay, Anton's gay, and then that basketball player that came out the closet, you all wanted me to comment on that. I don't care what's his name, Jason Collins. He's not even sexy. Like, you know, congrats on coming out. I just don't get why gay people have to make an announcement that they are. This world is obsessed with gay people, and I just don't get it. I don't care. Jason Collins, he's not my type, okay? I don't want that shit, okay? I would have been more impressed if Miss Bosch would have came out, honey. If Miss Chris Bosch would have came out, oh, baby, I would have been all over that story. But Jason Collins, exactly. Moving on. Moving on to one of my favorite porn stars of all time, Sister Patterson, and he's a straight porn star, Mr. Marcus. According to TMZ, porn star Mr. Marcus was pulled over in his Honda around 2:30 a.m. after he was observed weaving in and out of traffic. Mr. Marcus was pulled over, he failed a breathalyzer test, and was taken into custody. Not interesting, but you know, I just always used to love Mr. Marcus. I used to be, what, 13, 14? I used to go to Fordham Road. They used to sell, you know, them guys, them Africans, they used to sell the porn tapes on the streets. I used to always look for Mr. Marcus. You know what I mean? Nuts, I used to bust this nigga. I love Mr. Marcus. I will still suck that dick, even though I heard back in 2012 he had a syphilis outbreak. You didn't hear about that, baby? All the porn stars was getting all these diseases and syphilis, and all routed out back to one man. You, Mr. Marcus. But I don't care, baby. I still suck that dick. Give me syphilis. Oh, you don't know how bad I want to suck his dick. I used to be obsessed with Mr. Marcus. You all know who Mr. Marcus is. If you follow porn, you know who this is, baby. You know who this is. Now, did you hear that Malcolm Shabazz, the grandson of Malcolm X, well, he is dead, honey, okay? Rest in peace. Malcolm Shabazz, the troubled grandson of civil rights icon Malcolm X, has been killed in Mexico. The U.S. Embassy there confirms. News reports that Shabazz, who was 28... Hello, Peter! Sorry, God forgive me. I don't know why I'm laughing. Shabazz was thrown off a rooftop after being shot during an attempted robbery on Thursday, May 9th. I'm confirming on behalf of the family the tragic death of Malcolm Shabazz, grandson of Malcolm X. A statement from family... All right. Rest in peace, Malcolm, okay? I mean, who was this? Rest in peace, yeah, Malcolm. rest in peace, Malcolm. Okay, now you're gonna meet your grandfather, Malcolm. Rest in peace. Wow. Okay, you guys. Oh, real quick, Sister Patterson. I have to shout out to your homegirl in the name of hair, cause you know she like to wear her hair all natural. And that's Lauren Hill, Sister Patterson. I don't know if you heard, girl, but just sister, she was sentenced to 3 months in prison for failing to pay her taxes. Wow. Trouble single. Maybe she could grow her hair while she in jail. You know, do something, girl. Write some songs, honey. We want that. Oh, remember that old Lauren, that first Lauren Hill album, The Miseducation Lauren Hill? That was a classic, man. Maybe while she's in jail for Dreamer, she can get back to where she was. All right, you guys. That's your celebrity tea. Real quick, let's get into some sexiness. Because I know you all are sick of looking at my ugly ass for these past 30 minutes. So, baby, get into this sexy. This is some eye candy for you, baby, okay? Here's the first picture. Oh, wait, my bad. I'm sorry, that's not the picture. My bad mistake. But please, believe me, it's some of you download men out there. You know you be all up in them trannies' asses, okay? You will fuck them trannies down, honey. So don't sit up here and try to front for me. Anyway, let's get into dude number one. Wow, this is what you call sexy. Just yummy. What do you look like? Dominican Latino? That's sexy dude number one. Now, here is sexy dude number two. Oh, baby, he is blessed to be blessed to be blessed. This is what you call sexiness, baby. I am jealous. This is what you call fine. Wow. All right. And here's your last dude real quick. I call him Poppy. Yummy, yum, yum. I had to edit out his dick. But baby, if you want to see his dick, go to shutupbimbomyblog.com. And I have the uncensored pictures on there. He got a nice piece of meat. These dudes are just sexy, baby. Sexy. Alright, you guys. Real quick, I'm about to go check on my steak. And then I'm going to flip this video around. And we're going to get to your karaoke. Plus, I have an email, remember? And then your Loving It or Coming Again segment features Jaheim and his track called Age Ain't a Factor. You're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. You're not going to see this break, but I'm about to just flip the video. And then when we come back, we're going to get into some karaoke. I'm going to do Crisscross Jump Jump. You're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. Waka waka. Patterson. First, let me have a sip of my Long Island. Yes, baby. And next, steak is almost ready, but you know when you're cooking your steak, it smells so good. Just gotta go out there and get a nice piece of chunk. Tastes so good. Tastes so good. Oh, it tastes so good, baby. Tastes so good. Let's hurry up and finish this show so I can. You know, since my mother moved to Ohio, I had to learn how to cook. I told her, look, bitch, before you move, you're gonna teach me how to cook. So mama taught me how to cook, baby. I just can't make chicken cutlets. How do you make chicken cutlets? Like, I want to make the ones in the oven, honey, where you put the mozzarella cheese on it and the swirl, honey. Can someone leave in the comments or email me what's the best way to make the chicken cutlets? Look, all I want is the chicken cutlets, okay? The breast. And I just need to tell me the best sauce, okay? Don't be adding with your little extra stuff in it. I want simple chicken cutlets. I'm going to put over, like, some spaghettis. Alright, so let me know. Bimbo Winehouse, or leave it in the comments. I just want chicken parmesan, chicken cutlets. Break it down. Show me, you know, how many just break it down. Give me the proper ingredients, the measuring, everything. Chicken cutlets, okay? With the sauce and the Sis Patterson. I want to make that Saturday. So let me know. Help a queen out, honey, okay? Help a queen out, honey, okay? And also, told you I had my post box. What was it? P.O. box? Where's the information at? Sis Patterson. I think it was like P.O. Box 20. Aw, man. I'm sorry, you guys. Let me check one more place. If it's not... Oh, my God. I really lost it. I can't, man. I have my information. Oh, I got it, baby. Okay. I got it. If you want to send them some donations to this show, baby, or whatever you want to send to my show, if money, gifts, okay. My P.O. Box is... Deshawn Bimbo. That's D-E-S-H-A-W-N. Okay, my last name is Bimbo, B-I-M-B-O. And the P.O. Box is P.O. Box 602. And you want to send it to Mount Vernon, New York, 10551-0602, baby. See them gifts, honey. Send them gifts, honey, okay? I take whatever. You can send me a wig, okay? Some Bacardi, some money, some money orders. Okay, we take anything, honey, all right? Let me know if it's free, bitch. It's for me. All right, let's get into this karaoke. What's that? All right. I'm about to do Criss Cross, y'all. Bear with me. You all liked when I did Biggie Smalls, Big Papa. I'm about to do Mac Daddy and Daddy Mac. So, it's time for some karaoke on the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show, you guys. Alright, let's go. Yo, Criss Cross is not having it today. Yo, jump, the Mac Daddy will make ya. What? I'm nervous. Yo. Don't try to pay us to another bad little fat. I'm the Mac, I'm giving you something that you never had. I make you rock and wiggle and make you shake your rump, cause I be kicking a flavor that make you jump. How high, real high, cause I'm just a fly, a young, lovable, huggable type of guy. See, and every day to the back with us, cause inside, yo, is witty whack. I come stopping with something to keep you jumping. R&B, rap, bullcrap, what's what I'm dumping? Ain't something cross crap, believe that. When we say we rock, you better believe that. Bimbo will make you. Sister P will make you. Bimbo will make you. Bimbo will make you. Sister P will make you. The dildo will make you. Yeah, I like my stuff knocking. I love it when the king come jocking. Me, yeah, you know me. I got you jumping and pipping and popping round. Yo, I'm in the mix and I'm making six back. They try to step to the Bimbo, then they got jacked. They be back and sporting the gear that's causing to you. Act like you know it's mental. Two little queens with a flow that you never heard. Now fake you something, it's every word. As you can listen to my school melody, it's to make you want your J-U-M-P. What? Bimbo will make you. Sister P will make you. The dogs will make you. Yo. Bimbo will make you. Sister P will make you. Ow. Now, the formalities of this and that, okay? Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show is not whack. And all suckers that you think you know, check me out. But they can't. Some of them try to do it like this, but they can't. Some of them try to be like me, but they can't. Some of them try to be like me, cause I'm the queen of YouTube, bitch. Cause I'm the queen of YouTube, bitch. Cause I'm the queen. What? Bimbo will make you. Sister P will make you. Why? Come on, Sister P. Why? Bimbo. Yes, baby. Bimbo will make you.
I'm the Mac, baby. Give it to me, baby. Why? Zip it low. Zip it like that. Zip it low. What you think, baby? I can't. Jump, jump. Bimbo would make you. Well, that was karaoke with Bimbo. I'm twisted. Anyway, you guys, as you know, what's his name? Mac Daddy, today was his funeral. It was a tough day in Atlanta, Georgia, where the funeral of Crisscross rapper Chris Mac Daddy was held today. The church was filled with the family and friends, including members of the Escape Group and Kiki Wyatt, who all sang, as well as DeBrat and Jermaine Dupri, who was there, with their pants backward in tribute to Kelly. And of course, Chris Daddy Mac Smith, start crying, wasn't intended. He, had a hard time saying goodbye to his close friend of so many years. It's been like a struggle for me every day. I know Chris is in heaven. He was a true friend. I just want to say I love you, man, and I'm going to miss you daily. My life. My life is never gonna be the same, but I just hope our legacy for hip hop is never forgotten. I'm gonna do my part to make sure Chris' legacy will live on. Oh, God, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. I don't know where that came from. I'm sorry. I'm just thinking about you being so close to someone, and then wow. I don't know if you guys heard, but what led to Chris Kelly's death was, they said last week it was announced that rapper Chris Kelly, Mac Daddy, passed away. The reason, of course, was death was drugs. They said Chris had been clean for a while. He was off and on cocaine and heroin for the last 10 years, but had recently cleaned up his act. What fueled the drug was the Crisscross reunion concert. Sources claim that his ego blew up along with his wallet, and he started hanging out in the clubs again, chumming up with the big name Atlanta drug dealers. The drugs came back in full force as a result. Kelly's mother admitted to police that Chris had been taking speedballs, that's coke and heroin mixed together, Tuesday night, which was the night before his death. Wow. Rest in peace. But again, you guys, you know, hey, if the drugs make you happy, like Amy Winehouse, them drugs made her happy. I'm, you know, hey, if I die from liquor, it is what it is. This is what made me happy during my depressed times in life. Hey, moving on. Let me get to this quick email. Then we gotta go, you guys. But real quick, this is from, what is your name, child? What is your name? Oh, she said, hey, Bimbo, girl, my name's Dana, and I am bisexual. I am in high school, and I have a friend that I like. I recently texted her that I liked her, and she told me she wasn't gay. But in person, she cannot keep her hands off of me. She touches my ass and jumps on me a lot, and my other friends look at us like we are funny. She always tells me she loves me and everything. I just want to know if she likes me or not, because I think she's lying when she tells me she is not gay. Please respond ASAP. Love the show. Walker, Walker, M.
Dana, Dana, Dana. Oh, I wish I would have. Oh, I would have loved this. Like having a so-called straight friend. Me being gay in high school and having a straight. Like this is fun. This is some of the best times in high school. Having this type of relationship. Because the night that is going to go down, after that, is going to be boring. Like, you like the lead up. You know what I'm saying? Like, Dana, she's gay, okay? She's gay, believe me, she's gay. But I don't think I just don't think she can accept to it by you asking her. are you gay? She's not gonna say yes, I'm gay. What you need to do, Dane, this is what you need to go. You need to do. You need to get her in your house, in your room, one night, and y'all need to get drunk, honey. Okay, preferably Long Island iced tea, honey. Okay, get her nice and right, and then I want you to look in her eyes and say, look, I know you want me, and I want you to. I know you want me bad, and I want you. And then after that, Dana, I want you just to grab her and just, baby. And then take it from there, but from this email, she's gay, okay? She just don't want to say it out loud. Like, you know how some people is gay, just don't want to say I'm gay, but they gay, okay? So, do what I said. Get her in that room one night. You two alone, no other friends. Get some get right, whatever you do, you little young kids do to get yourself, you know, there. Do that, okay? But believe me, honey, she's gay. Let me know. Let me see a picture, honey. Okay, honey? Because she's touching you and feeling you. Oh, she's a meatball, one or two. I cannot stand them stupid meatball friends. You know the ones who play. If I ain't got time for that, okay? But anyway, back to you, young. Get her, Dana. Get that pussy, bitch. Get that pussy. Because she wants you to eat it. Or she want to eat your pussy. However it goes. But listen to me, bitch. You two have to be alone. No texting, okay? Because what she probably be thinking is you around some other peoples who's really, yeah, this girl is gay. Don't do that. You two need to be alone. And you need to make it happen, bitch. Okay? Make it happen. Shout out to all you people who can't come to true terms of who you truly are, honey, okay? It's alright, baby. It's alright. Anyway, you guys, I thank you for checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show. Another show. Sister Patterson, I'm ready to go eat. Remember, you can send me some gifts. Here is the info. It's Deshaun Bimbo, and it's P.O. Box 602, Mount Vernon, New York, 10551-0602. I'll be back with another show tomorrow. And before we go, I told you I wanted to get into Jaheim's new song. This is the Loving It or Coming Again song, and the track is called Please Work. The track is called, what's the track called? Oh, it's called AJ and a Factor. So let me know what you think of this track. And my baby, this is new Jaheim. Oh, by the way, Jaheim, I know something about you, Jaheim. Yes, I do. But you know I ain't want to gossip, baby. You know I don't gossip, honey. I like to, you know, I don't like to talk about people. But I know what you do and your career is. You gotta make these females want you, baby. But I know what you do, honey. Okay? Alright, but anyway, you all, let me know what you think of this new Jaheim track, honey, okay? But Jaheim, alright, you guys, this is new Jaheim. This is called AJ and a Factor. It's new R&B, baby. You checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction Show? Let me know what you think of this track. My. Once again, this is called AJ and a Factor, new Jaheim. Let me know what you think. Are you loving this track or he needs to come again, honey? Alright, I'll talk to you all tomorrow in the next show. All right, talk to you all tomorrow. Let me know what you think of this track. Bye.